Hot sauce. Look out for that hot sauce. Welcome to Think About It Reviews, and I am here to talk about Top 5, written and directed by Chris Rock. This film seems like it is just all about Chris Rock. It's about a comedian who basically wants to leave the comedy side and be taken seriously. You know, he has an alcohol addiction. He is being interviewed by Rosario Dawson and her character for The Times. And basically, it's just like a documentary type film. I love Rosario Dawson. I always love her. Chris Rock, it's whether either you like him or you really don't. I'm actually really neutral with him. I remember he was playing at the Shoemash Casino, and I really stand up, and I got tickets to go see him. And at first, you know, Chris Rock, I didn't think he was that funny as I saw him on television and other things in the media. But then when I went to go see him, man, that guy is pretty hysterical comedy-wise. And either you like his voice or you don't. His voice does be a little bit annoying at some times. But we're not talking about Chris Rock. That's just my views on Chris Rock himself. This film, it's okay. It's not going to be a memorable film. It's an okay film. It wasn't that funny, which is really a shocker. There was only maybe three scenes in this film where it was actually pretty hysterical. Once Chris Rock meets Cedric the Entertainer, and his character was pretty hilarious. That was probably the most funniest moment in the film. Also, the other time is when he goes and visits his family in, I believe, Brooklyn. And then also towards the very end of the film as well. That involves hot sauce. Well, this overall, his direction was not too bad. It was well directed. The only problem I had with it was some shots were way too close in. So when the actors would, you know, move around, they would be out of frame. And sometimes they're just too close to the face. That's fine. But overall, it was well directed. It was well edited, too. There was a lot of times in this film where it goes back and forth in the flashbacks, or when he's making a reference to something. It's like a Family Guy type deal, which was fine as well. The editing was really crisp, and you got it. You never were confused by any of the going back and forth in time, so very good use of editing. I believe, though, the acting was fine. Like I said, either you're going to like Chris Rock or you don't, because Chris Rock in this film, it's all about him, and it's about his character Andre Ellington, but it seemed like it was just about Chris Rock. Chris Rock is not trying to be anybody else but Chris Rock. That's the thing. So either you really like Chris Rock or not. The writing in this movie was not that great. It's very generic, very, you know, cliche. You've seen all this stuff done before. I can't even say it was done, you know, very well, because it was very lackluster. At times, I was a little bit bored. Like I said, it didn't really hit until you really go into when he meets Cedric the Entertainer's character. But overall, I mean, it was an okay film. I think it's gaining a lot of buzz. And, I mean, it's his first directing and writing credits for a film. I mean, but you gotta love that Pootie Tang. I don't know why I was watching this film. I was like, man, I remember when he came out. Pootie Tang was an awesome movie. But overall, it was a fine film. I didn't hate it. I always say that I didn't hate it, but you know, it's not gonna stick with me in the long run. And I think that's the problem with this film. Like I said, there's only a few laughs, not too many laugh out moments, which is kind of ironic since, you know, Chris Rock doesn't feel funny. And the one time he was funny was when he ends up in some of his stand-up, which was not too funny, but it was chuckle funny. There wasn't a lot of laugh out loud moments. And I think in this type of film, I think he wanted to be taken seriously as a director and as a writer, but it just really, you've seen it all before. There's really nothing really new to it. And I gotta disagree with him like hell about his top five and a lot of people others' top five. I was like, why are they playing a lot of Jay-Z music in here? The music in this film, you know, you heard a lot of hip-hop and stuff. It was pretty good. I was like, why are they playing a lot of Jay-Z? Ha! I stayed for the credits, and Jay-Z was producer. Mr. Carter was a producer in this film. And of course, he's in the top five of all time MCs, which I totally disagree. I mean, it's Chris Rock's opinion and everybody else's, but I wonder why Jay-Z's getting so much love in this film, and you see it. He's a producer. Yeah, that's there we go. I thought but Cedric the Entertainer, you know, that scene was just hilarious. I thought it was so funny how they set that all up. Like I said, it definitely has that nitty gritty documentary type deal. So go in looking, if you're going to go watch this, yeah, just don't, maybe you'll get a big laugh out of it, but don't expect too much laughing, because it really was kind of a generic film. Do I recommend this film? No, I can't recommend it. It's really just kind of, you wait till it comes on Redbox and you go buy it. It's really not something you go out and go see. I've asked a lot of people, you know, they ask me, what did you go watch? I go, I watched Top 5. And they go, what's Top 5? A lot of people don't know about this movie when it's been advertised quite a bit. So they don't know really much about what's Top 5. I'm like, it's the one with Chris Rock. And then they have to pause and think a little bit. And then they remember. So I don't know how this film's going to do over the weekend, especially with all this controversy going on with the interview and stuff. And you know how people feel about the movie theaters, bringing back old memories. But Top 5, I mean, I don't recommend it. So, I mean, if you're thinking about watching it, by all means, go check it out. Let me know what you think of the movie, because this is just my thoughts, my opinions. I'm not really telling you not to watch it. So, but if you are dead set watching it, let me know what you think. Comment below. If you like this video, please push the like button and please subscribe for more. I got more reviews on the way. And my Top 5, come on, Tupac. That's all I need. That's all I need. And if somehow there was no Tupac music in the world, then I'll have my backup Lupe Fiasco or Tribe Called Quest. But you know, I'll give you a serious top five. My top five: Tupac, Lupe Fiasco, Tribe Called Quest, Atmosphere. What else should I go? You know what? Gangstar, and then my sixth man. You know what? I'm sixth man. Ooh, this is a hard one. Sixth man. Who's it gonna be? Drum roll, please. I honestly can't think about who's my sixth man. That's a hard one. But those are my top five. Basically, sixth man will probably be. Well, I guess you can't place a group in it. I don't know. I don't know what my sixth man be. This is a good discussion. But, yeah, that's my top five. And that's it, guys. So grab a tick, grab a seat, enjoy some good popcorn. I hope you have some good popcorn to eat. See you at the cinema.